Florida has always taken a leadership role in the management of our saltwater fisheries, fisheries research, and extensive outreach and education efforts to keep anglers informed. These programs, along with our laboratories, rank among the finest in the world, generating invaluable data to provide management with the information necessary to develop a hands-on approach to protecting our fish stocks and their habitat. Because Florida is surrounded by oceans and boasts more than 500 native species of saltwater fish, this proactive approach to fisheries management is crucial to the sustainability of marine resources. I'm Mark Sosin, and fishing Florida's waters has been an ongoing passion since I stood waist high to my father. Join me as we take a closer look at some programs that help to conserve fisheries resources and where the money comes from to pay for them. Some 60 years ago, Congressman John Dingell of Michigan and Senator Edwin Johnson of Wyoming had a vision. They wanted the federal government to help support fisheries across the land. So they sponsored the Sport Fish Restoration Act, establishing cooperation between state and federal governments to provide funds for everything from fisheries research to teaching youngsters to fish. This legislation puts a 10% excise tax on almost all fishing tackle and on certain boating items. The tax is paid by the manufacturer and passed along to the consumer. So every time you buy tackle, you are contributing to this valuable fund. Then in 1984, Congressman John Brough and Senator Malcolm Wallop authored a bill that expanded Dingell Johnson and incorporated a percentage of the tax on marine fuel. As part of the program, 15% of this money would be earmarked for the building and improvement of boating facilities. The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service collects these funds and then redistributes them to the states based on the number of licensed anglers and the total land and water area of the state. No state gets less than 1% or more than 5% of the fund. Each state is then required to cover 25% of the cost of any project. Sportfish restoration funding pays for the other 75%. So anytime you see the Sportfish restoration logo on a boat ramp, remember that you help pay for it by purchasing your fishing tackle and boat fuel. It's important to recognize that on a state basis, most of the revenue from fishing license sales in Florida complements funds through Sportfish Restoration to help finance a number of projects for the benefit of fishermen and boaters. Angler education, stock enhancement, artificial reefs, and a variety of game fish research projects are all recipients of these monies. With the help of Sportfish Restoration funds, more than 200 boat ramps around the state are maintained and more are being built. These ramps offer access to some of the most productive fishing waters in Florida. In order to maintain this level of fishing productivity, fisheries managers rely on marine fisheries research, which provides vital information to inform the management process and help maintain sustainable populations. A variety of research projects are conducted annually around the state to gather information on various life history aspects of saltwater fish. Some researchers monitor the health of sport fish, while others continually collect biological statistics such as distribution, abundance, and behavior for a number of different species. For example, biologists use genetic samples obtained through angler catches of tarpon to gain insight into their movement and distribution, as well as their ability to withstand fishing pressures. Starting in 1996, Florida has taken a proactive approach to promote fisheries conservation early in an angler's career by holding kids fishing clinics. The clinics focus on teaching participants the basics of fish and catch and release practices, as well as the concepts of marine resource management and personal stewardship of the environment. As a part of clinic activities, participants get to interact firsthand with marine creatures at the touch tank, which is always a popular station. 13 of these clinics are held around the state annually, with at least 5,000 young anglers participating each year and some 70,000 since the project began. Thousands of parents take part in clinic activities with their children, as well as countless volunteers from local communities, without whom the clinics could not function. Now numbering more than 2,500, artificial reefs dot the Florida coast, strategically placed in water depths from 12 to 300 feet. These reefs provide critical habitat for countless marine species, including invertebrates, and help to concentrate fish populations. Published coordinates make it easy for anyone to locate these reefs. The Federal Sportfish Restoration Program grants some $700,000 annually to fund the placement of artificial reefs in Florida and to scientifically monitor the existing ones. In the last 30 years, Florida has spent some $18 million on artificial reef development. In return, these reefs stimulate Florida's economy because millions of dollars are spent each year by fishermen and divers who are lured to the bounties of our artificial reefs. Sportfish restoration has also made it possible to produce a number of marine fisheries-related publications. Boating and Angling Guides, published by the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission in partnership with many other organizations, offer information on major waterways in more than 25 coastal regions around the state. Each one contains a wealth of data on marinas, boat ramps, restaurants, the location of artificial reefs, and natural resources such as seagrasses and marshes. All of these guides are provided free of charge to the public. An angler and boater outreach exhibit featuring a 500-gallon aquarium containing various species and marine life travels to several fishing-related shows and venues each year. You may also see FWC staff at your local boat ramp, handing out publications on fisheries conservation and answering any questions you may have. These local appearances are part of a new program called Angler Intercepts. Outreach events such as these give FWC staff an opportunity to share information with the public on a personal basis and make people aware of current sportfish restoration funded projects and how they can participate in fisheries conservation. A series of 6 posters designed to help anglers identify and distinguish between different types of marine fish species includes baitfish, groupers, snappers, pelagics, inshore species, and jacks. Each poster provides detailed illustrations of the various fish, helping anglers to identify them. These posters can be framed and hung on the wall for continuous reference. Another publication, Fishing Lines, an Angler's Guide to Florida's Marine Resources, is published with the help of Sportfish Restoration. It offers information on Florida's marine fishing resources, a detailed explanation of major fish habitats, benefits of catch and release, and an illustrated guide to 114 species of fish. 4-page brochures called Sea Stats cover a number of marine species, offering basic scientific information about each one, including ongoing research of the species. They are designed to help anglers better understand the life cycles of the species they are targeting. Finally, a series of short videos such as the one you're watching now have been produced to provide interesting programs for fishing clubs, or they can be obtained for individual viewing. These videos highlight sportfish restoration funded programs in Florida and present a variety of information to the viewer that can be utilized to help protect and conserve Florida's marine resources. The DVDs, along with the other products mentioned, are available free of charge from the FWC, courtesy of the Sportfish Restoration Program. Florida's fisheries not only provide recreational activities for countless residents, but they also serve as a magnet to draw great numbers of visitors to the Sunshine State. Tourism is a major industry in Florida and helps to fuel our economy. Fishing in Florida is big business. This is one of the many reasons it is imperative that we maintain the quality of our fisheries and the quality of the habitat that supports it. With the help of Sportfish Restoration Grants, the money is available to support marine fisheries research, as well as programs that educate anglers to our needs and help them understand they are a fisheries manager every day they are on the water. When all of us work together, Florida will remain the fishing capital of the world for years to come.